Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to discuss about the facial artery and its branches. Here in this picture, you can see the common carotid artery, which divides into internal carotid artery and external carotid artery. Now here, it is the facial artery. So facial artery originates from external carotid artery. It initially lies beneath the platysma muscle. Here this is mandible and this is masseter muscle. So facial artery, it passes deep to the stylohyoid and posterior belly of digastric muscle and emerges over the edge of mandible, just anteroinferior portion of masseter muscle, where you can feel the pulse. Now let's see what are the branches of facial artery. It gives total 8 branches mainly. We can divide it into two parts, cervical part and facial part. Cervical part contains 4 branches: tonsillar branch, ascending palatine artery, submental artery, and glandular branch. And facial part contains 4 branches: inferior labial artery, superior labial artery, lateral nasal branch to nasalis muscle, and angular artery, it is the terminal branch. Now here it is palatine tonsil. The tonsillar branch ascends between the pterygoideus internus and styloglossus muscle and then along the side of pharynx, perforating the constrictor pharynx superior, it supplies the palatine tonsil and root of the tongue. Next is ascending palatine artery, which runs up the superior pharyngeal constrictor muscle up to the soft palate area and mainly supplies 4 important structures: palatine tonsil, soft palate, levator valley palatini muscle, and auditory tube. Now come to the submental artery. It runs on the underside of the chin and runs forward upon the mylohyoid muscle, just below the body of mandible and beneath the digastric muscle. It supplies the surrounding muscles and anastomosis with the sublingual artery and mylohyoid branch of inferior alveolar artery. It also supplies a territory of skin in the submental area. Next is glandular branch. This branch consists of 3 to 4 large vessels which supply the submandibular gland and sometimes neighboring muscles, lymph glands, and skin. Now come here. I have drawn 2 important facial muscles, orbicularis oris and depressor anguli oris. From the anteroinferior angle of masseter muscle, facial artery passes forward and upward direction across the cheek and angle of mouth area, where it gives 2 branches, superior labial artery and inferior labial artery. Inferior labial artery passes upwards and forwards under the depressor anguli oris muscle and it penetrates the orbicularis oris muscle. Superior labial artery also have the same relation with the orbicularis oris muscle and depressor anguli oris muscle. Now inferior labial artery supplies the inferior labial glands, mucous membrane, and muscles of the surrounding area. Superior labial artery is large and more tortuous. It supplies the upper lip. It gives off a alar branch and septal branch, which ramifies anteroinferiorly in the nasal septum. Next branch is lateral nasal artery, which supplies the dorsum and ala of the nose and anastomosis with the other side, lateral nasal artery. Sometimes this artery may be replaced by a branch from the superior labial artery. Next is angular artery, which is the terminal part of the facial artery. It ascends to the medial angle of the eye's orbit and supplies lacrimal sac and orbicularis oculi muscle. Now some clinical points. Here I would like to mention 3 important clinical points. First is facial artery is accompanied by facial vein throughout the courses. Next point is facial artery is remarkably tortuous. This tortuous course prevents the artery being getting stretched during movement of mandible or movement of facial muscles. And the last point is, it is commonly palpated at the anterior inferior angle of masseter muscle against the base of the mandible. That's all, guys. If you have enjoyed this video, please like, comment and share, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.